Hello and thank you for watching. My name is Merginator and this is the Blancpain going around spa. I qualified like ass. I'm in 10th place, so pretty much at the end of the pack. So here is race one. Of course, you know, rolling start. Lap two is technically the first lap, and we have Hooligan Hard trying to get that Mercedes in there with the quickness, but getting a little too aggressive and then backing out. Someone joins the party, and I'm trying not to let that distract me as I race and commentate. So here we have Yankees fan just in front of me in that Audi of Intimidator in front of him in the Jaguar coming through Eau Rouge. And then this is probably the hardest part of the track. It's really hard to get that correct. Maintain enough speed, because if you slow down too much, you will lose out. Seriously, it's like you lose 2 seconds coming through Eau Rouge, coming out of it, and going down this entire straight. It really matters. So here we have some traffic, and I'm going to make the most of it as a Yankees fan gets through. Speedy Jab on the outside, and Sarvarius just in front in that big boy Bentley. And we're going to have one really aggressive lunge here by Speedy Jab. And I am able to actually just follow him through without touching Sarvarius. Sarvarius loses two positions there. And I'm able to get through. But here we are at the end of that same lap. Sarvarius carrying enough speed through that turn. Going to try to go on the outside of Speedy Jab here. I'm going to tuck in behind him. Make a little mistake there. And we have Yankees fan going too deep and kind of just parking it so he doesn't have to enter the track in a goofy manner. So his mistake just benefits us all. Hitman, one of the elites here in the Pro-Am division, has been doing really well this series, and I was able to get around him just there on the straight coming out of Eau Rouge into this section here. I'm not too familiar with the names of the turns, so I apologize for my unprofessionalism, and he's able to get the cutback on me. I didn't have the proper line going through there, apparently. I didn't carry enough speed, and Hitman gets his spot back. The end of lap five, though, coming back towards that final chicane, he's going to take the inside line. And at this point, I know I'm a little faster than him coming around Spa, which is weird to say because usually I'm way slower than him. So I jump into the pits to see if I can get some good laps. So lap seven, he's coming out of the pits. I'm going way too wide. So Hitman comes out of the pits. I should barely have enough speed to get around him, but Sarvarius just powerhousing around me. They're going to go two by two. Into Eau Rouge, Sarvarius backs off just a little bit, tapping Hitman. Hitman and I take the worst line possible, very slow, even cutting, so none of that benefit our performance. And here on the last lap, we have Black Ghost and I believe Speedy Jab making contact with one another. So that's going to be two positions gained on the last lap there on race one. So luckily for me, qualified in 10th. I finished the race in 6th place, which is usually my highest spot in a race, and that puts me in 3rd place for Pro-Am for that race. Here we are, race 2, pretty much rinse and repeat of exactly what happened the race before, except this happens. Hooligan Hart, of course, going in for the lunge, and J-Mill spins me out. It was an accident, not a big deal, and of course, there's no damage, so there's not going to be any restart. So at this point, I have to claw my way back from last place. J-Mill had the speed to get into Eau Rouge faster than I did, so I backed off. However, I have the better exit speed coming out, and I'm going to try to capitalize on that. As he is on the inside for the next turn, he is in the better position to go through those S's. And I don't know what happens here, but I'm able to get... He just brakes, backs out. And so I have my usual racing line here. And then this is where traffic comes into play. Cold tires, I don't know what happened there, but he's going to go into the grass. Those two make contact and kind of slow each other down, get it into the grass just a little bit. And then you see Intimidator going a little wide. So there we are. I've already made 4 positions up, and we're not even halfway through the lap. And here we are later on in that lap. Intimidator coming towards this really sexy fast left-hander. And I'm able to get past him on that. So in that first lap, there is 5 positions gained. Sarvarius going into a drift and taking his Bentley to the beach for the day. Now, there was not enough action to really post anything else. But I will say I will show this entire last lap in full, because we have Speedy Jab here in 6th place. And after all was said and done with pit strategies, he was 3.5 seconds behind me. And his pace was stellar. He was gaining on me 0.5 seconds every lap. And on this final lap, he is just right behind me. So I'm going to try to be as defensive as possible while also keeping my pace. He goes for a lunge. I'm not going to give him any room. And then try to maintain speed going through these S's. Now I'm also trying to catch up with Black Ghost. I'm not trying to just focus on defending and blocking. I'm trying to also keep up my pace just in case those two in front of me, which is Chuckles and Black Ghost, if those two make a mistake, I end up on podium. So I'm trying to keep my composure, trying to keep my head while still trying to hold my position, because finishing in fifth place would be my highest finish of the season, which is amazing considering these guys just have good experience with these crew, and I don't know. It would just be nice to have a top five finish. So Speedy Jab, making his presence aware. I lose too much speed going through here, so I drop it down into second place. He is on my inside for the next turn, which is not good for me. I'm going to brake way later than I normally would, and also accelerate. Aggressively cut right in front of him there because I had the space to do it, so it was my apex to claim, and I took it. This was one of my favorite battles of the entire season because we were side by side for so long, and I'm going to try to make no mistakes here, not go wide or anything. I carried a lot of speed through that turn compared to most of the drivers. I gained a lot of time there. Going into the final chicane, though, accidentally cut that because I misjudged it. Drop it down to first and just keep it easy not to spin the tires, even though I do have stability on. And I am successful in holding down fifth place. My fastest time was a dirty lap, but it was a 2:19, which was 5 seconds faster than my qualifying lap. So while racing, I found my pace. Finished in fifth place in race two, which is actually second in Pro-Am. So that is great points for me. Thank you so much for watching. Next week is Long Beach for the finale. I appreciate you watching. Leave comments down below. Leave a like. Share with your friends. I appreciate you all, and I'll see you in the next race. Bye-bye.